Alright, so this is how you remove the brake rotors on the rear of a Mitsubishi Pajero Montero Shogun. So the car's been jacked up and put on stands. Make sure, because you're going to have released the handbrake while you're working on this, that you chock the front wheels with something. I just used the tyres, just so it doesn't roll away. Now, these guys here can seize on. So the first thing we're going to do is just put a little bit of spray around here. You can use Inox or WD-40 or any other penetrating lubricant will do the job. So that goes in there, and then we take off the brake caliper. Because you've got the brake hose coming up here, you won't be able to move this, get this bolt out here. So what you do is take the bottom one out first. Oh, there's a spider. I don't like spiders. And then you can pull it out and away like that. Okay, keep that there. Don't let the caliper drop on the hose, as it can damage the hose. Next thing, you want to take off the caliper bracket. So get these pads out of here first too. These are pretty well stuck in there, not too well. The wear's not too bad on these actually, that's pretty good, but yeah, I've got a problem with this here. So I'm getting the rotors machined. But at least the pads are still even. There's a little screw here on the back, just in here, that's bolted to the splash plate and it won't come out, so that's a 10 mil. So just undo that one. Now this is usually the really tricky part here, because the rotor will sometimes seize onto the studs here. So there's two things you can do. You can either give it a couple of good firm strikes in between the studs with a hammer. Never, ever, ever, ever hit the actual braking surfaces of the rotor unless you're gonna chuck them out. If you're gonna reuse them, don't hit the braking surfaces, because you will damage them. The other thing you can do is on these Pajeros, you've got these two little holes here where you can put two small bolts. Not exactly sure what size they are, sorry about that. I just grabbed some from the bolt bucket. And that will push the rotor off the axle. See? Like that. And that can save you smashing things, possibly damaging the threads here, other things like that. So, and then pull it off, that's it. Done. So now we come to refitting the brake rotor. I bought some new ones here because my other ones were undersized and they couldn't be machined. So this one's got a black coating on it, this particular brand here, so you don't need to clean it down and wash it off, because some of the other brands of disc brakes come with an oil on there, so you've got to clean that off. Don't need to do it with this particular one, but I'm still going to wear these gloves because I don't want to get crud all over the braking surfaces. So now comes the part where we reattach the caliper bracket here. Do these up really tight and they'll be nice and firm. So now we reset the piston caliper here, and if you haven't got the exact tool for it, you can just use an old brake pad and a clamp. Put that in there like so. It should go back easy. If it doesn't, then you've got a problem with the actual piston sticking and you'll need to get the caliper overhauled. Okay, so I put the brake pads on. Now this guy here has got a little wear indicator on it. This goes to the piston side, so the inside of the caliper in here. And the other one goes on the outside here. The pins will get a little coat of this anti-seize grease, so put that on them. Sure that these little rubber boots that are on the caliper bracket don't get crushed when you slide the caliper in place. So when you slide that back in place there, this boot can distort and then you can damage it when you slide the pin into it. Couple of taps with the hammer just to lock it in place there. So make sure it's nice and tight. Good. Done. And that's the brakes done. Now you can just chuck the wheel on and bed them in and it's all good.